Trying to go natural.
Hi everyone, welcome to my channel. DWD, I guess, dripping wet day. Coming on to do a wash and go, coming on to do a fun video and a kind of challenge and review all in one for you guys. These are two products that I've heard from my subbies are just the best thing ever, and I decided why not just pair them and see for myself. So it's my first time trying both of these, I'm pairing them. I'm gonna let you know and let myself know if these are really the best natural hair products ever. One is the Curls Blueberry Bliss Leave-In Conditioner, which I know we've all heard about from like day one, from the beginning. It's the best thing ever. And the other is this Miel Honey and Ginger Styling Gel. This got rave reviews when it first came out. Of course, I'm late on both of these, but this is the point. Let me catch myself up, let me catch you up, and let's see how good they really are. But it's flat, but not completely weighed down, so it's looking good so far. Let's apply to this side and see how it goes. So this is before the product. Let me get going before it dries anymore, because you all know I do my wash and goes usually on soaking wet hair. I haven't tried the dry wash and go yet, I don't think. Maybe in desperation sometime, but not on video. Yeah, let's get started. So the first thing to note about this Curls Leave-In is that it's really thick. Trying to get it out. The first thing to note about this Curls Leave-In is that it's really thick, so it's like rolling down my hand. So it's definitely the Team Rich and Creamy, which I think a lot of the earlier products were. I'm not generally on Team Rich and Creamy, but this leave-in definitely is there. And I can say from doing the rest of my hair that it's fine, like so far. The slip is just okay, but definitely not bad. So meaning that I personally wouldn't detangle with it, but on already detangled hair, you can see that it'll get you there. You can apply easily. So I like that. Has a nice mild scent, so I like that as well. Like my hair almost wants to panic about how thick it is, but it actually is penetrating decently on my low porosity hair. And I like that my hair is feeling kind of juicy and moisturized right now. So let's apply the gel. Oh, but before we apply the gel, I'm gonna add some oil, because the gel has carbama and I'm really not trying to be played this week. So the oil is gonna help prevent my hair from getting dry from the carbama, and also help prevent any kind of flakes and interaction between the leave-in and the gel. This is my little oil mix. I do wanna do a video on Oilgate, because I know this oil has a bad rep these days, but it works for me, it helps me out. So this is my oil. Not a whole lot, just kind of greasing my palm and then getting it everywhere. And that's it for my oil application. Just working that in now. Prevent dryness in the case where something in the product dries out your hair. You want to maybe put some oil under it. Also crunch. Like, I don't know if this is going to have crunch, but just in case the gel has crunch, because I don't like crunch. Oil helps to cut crunch, prevent flakes. This is with the oil. And now let's add the gel and see what we get. So one thing I will say about this gel, first of all, let me count the ways I like this gel. Doesn't have a super strong scent like the first batch of Miel products that just had super strong scents. This has a nice mild, I guess, honey ginger scent, but the key word is mild, so I can get with it. Her first set of products, the scents were really strong. I'm not even somebody who cares about strong scents, but they were too strong for me. Second, it's like super thick, which is interesting. This is like the thickest gel. I mean, it's not carbamey, which is third, meaning that it's not like completely synthetic feeling. It still feels kind of soft and not super slimy, but still soft. It doesn't feel like Eco Styler, but it's like super thick. This is the first gel I've tried where I can put it in my hand and get it onto my hair without worrying about it. Like, this is staying on my hands, no drip, no fuss, no muss. And I would say a little goes a long way as well. So those are all great points about this gel. I'm just getting it near the roots and then ends. I don't do super small sections. If you subscribe to my channel, you know that. Just trying to get it on and done. Step one, I kind of just smooth it down to help stretch the hair and minimize any tangles, I guess, for when I do my work through of raking. And you can see, I don't know if you can see, but I can tell from feeling it that the size of the fluff has gone down, which means that there is some clumping action. That's good if you're using a gel, that's kind of what you want. My hair doesn't feel weighed down, and it doesn't give me that carbama thing where it's sucking the water out of my hair. I can still feel the water in my hair. So stage two is where I just rake. And I do optionally add some more water just to help it spread better, but so far so good. Right, a bit more water, so now you see the raking is going way smoother. So the slip-on mist is good, the clamping definition is good, it feels moisturized, it smells great, so as long as it doesn't give me any flakes, I guess we'll be winning. So far the gel really could be a thing. Feels pretty well distributed. So I'm gonna do a little bit more smoothing. I like to end with a smoothing. I don't know why, I just do. So my smooth is gonna look like this, and I'm gonna shake and get some more volume. Yeah, I guess that's it. Let me do my shake. You can see that it looks pretty defined. My bathroom is always a disaster, like shaked onto the wall and all that. But anyways. Best products ever, it's possible, still possible. But we can't decide until it dries, can we? So see you in a bit. And this is my result. So I definitely like it. I did touch it, I don't know why I just did that. But I like it, so I like the definition. Plus, of course, I like the shape. This is not max shrinkage for me, believe it or not. Even though it is a lot of shrinkage, but so if you're worried about shrinkage, it isn't like, it does kind of probably elongate a little bit, I don't know. but I like the shape, I like how soft it is, you know, I hate crunch. Yeah, definitely be enjoying my week, so I'm happy with it. I don't think I would necessarily repurchase the leave-in, it didn't wow me. I prefer my current issue, I think still is sometimes because frizz was, I prefer that. Just because the slip wasn't that great and the thickness was just a bit on the scary side for my low porosity hair. Like I said, it penetrated, but my hair was a little bit like, what are we doing? And I was like, be calm, it's working, be calm. So yeah, I don't think I'll put myself through that again. So the ingredients on this are actually pretty good. Especially for curls, I've noticed sometimes curls can kind of be hit or miss with the ingredients. But the ingredients on this one, no complaints. This one has an even lighter, slightly sweet candy-ish type scent. Nice scent, nice moisture. The definition was okay as well, not like the most defined ever from a leave-in, but the definition was okay as well. So I definitely won't knock this, and I can see why people like it. Let me know if you love this, because I've definitely heard lots of subbies say this is the best thing ever. Gotta get it, gotta try it, it's gonna rock my world and all that. I do like my result overall, but I want to say the star of the show probably was this gel. I did like this. So this actually does have some carbomer in it, like I said, but this is how you block carbomer. Because when I was putting it on, I wasn't getting that carbomer feeling, and I definitely don't have that carbomer feeling in my hair right now. You know, if I had to call it, compare it to something with carbomer, it might be like the Eco Styler Gold or something. Meaning like still soft even though it has carbomer. So I don't normally like shea butter too much in my products, but I can see it might be good for counteracting, potentially, the carbomer. Definitely glycerin heavy because it's like water, glycerin, then honey, then aloe vera juice. So it has the acrylase copolymer as well as carbomer and copolymer, so kind of all the typical kind of cheap gelling ingredients, but then it also has like the pectin and the xanthan gum around it. I'm not really too sure about the benzyl alcohol at the very bottom, but with it being like a cheaper price point than like Uncle Funky and the Camille Rose, and with it like a little going a long way like I said, and it being moisturizing and so on, I'm willing to give it another try even though it has those other ingredients, because it does have some good stuff as well. I don't have any crunch, nice volume, nice lightness, nice definition, and I'm gonna be enjoying my week. Best products ever, no. Great product, yes. Nice product, yes. And I'm looking forward to using this again a few more times, just to explore it a bit more. I wanted to come on and put together something kind of like a response video to some of my comments from my subbies in terms of like the products that they really love. So if you have other products that you really love and I have to try, let me know in the comments down below, and it might be in a future video. You never know. Not my best natural hair products ever, but definitely worth a shot, and I liked my results. So see you in the next one, guys. Thanks for watching. Bye.